Hi all, welcome to John's Ball of Making. Today we've got Titanic issue 64. Excellent. I hope you've enjoyed 61, 62 and 63. Quite lengthy videos for the Titanic, but that is what it is. Today we got the superstructure and we have some more of those reflective stickers to attach underneath here. I did actually blacken it out. So that is the area. We've got three stickers to put in place. We've also got to remove these white foam stickers for smaller ones. So we'll get on with that first and then we can attach that to the decking. We can connect the wiring up and we can have a look at all the lighting. We also need to screw that to the boat decking. And then we can attach the section of hull onto the ship. Excellent stuff. So let's have a look at the instructions. And here we have the Titanic, the ship, the legend, issue 64. And coming in issue 65, the next hull section plus bracket and screws. And here we have the first of the two stories in this magazine. That's a very interesting read. Gentleman there from Haiti, unfortunately perished on the Titanic. And then we have another story, Progress in Physics. Very interesting read. And then we have the instructions, fourth section, the upper port side of the hull. There's a superstructure, and there we have three reflective stickers. Pop them into place, like I've just said, and we replace these two foam stickers and replace them with smaller ones. Then we put the superstructure onto the boat deck. We can connect all the wiring up, but it's probably best to actually screw that together first. 12 screws should have 12 AP screws somewhere, and then it's just a matter of interconnecting. I'll test it. There's another sticker there, and it's just to keep a wire in place or a cable. And there we have, this is when they actually ask you to connect the superstructure to the decking. Well, it's probably best to do that first if we're going to turn it over. And then we have some parts from issue 60 to fit in place on one of the previous issues. Then it's the hull section. There we go, with that cross strut as well. And that is what we're left with. So without further ado, let's get on with the build. Here we have the parts. Okay, though, so those are the parts from issue 64. There is the fourth hull section, upper port side. That hull though needs clearing. It's got a little bit of flash in there. Paint or whatever. Nice detail. And two doors. There's that cross support. That looks fine. And we got the LM and AM screws. But we also need these parts from issue 60. I think 60L and 60M. Reflective stickers. These adhesive stickers. And we need 12 AP screws to put the superstructure into place. So here we have the superstructure. Now the first thing we need to do really is to remove this off there because it's just getting in the way, because we have three reflective stickers to place here, here and here. Okay, look, that's come off as well. So just bear with me. So to start off with, I remove the PCB and the funnel just so I can get that piece into place correctly. Makes it a lot easier because that PCB in the last issue just got in the way. So we'll take the first strip off, which is number one, and that window's not popped out just like the previous lot. There we go. There we go. And that will go down here. Now I've got some water, so I'm gonna dip this in a little water and slide it into position. Okay, let's give that a whirl. Seems to have gone there all right. Thank you.
Excellent. That one nice and easy, that one. We'll mop that water up in a minute. Next we need. So that was the first sticker. Sticker one. Now we just need number two, which goes on top. I don't think we'll need any water. Yeah, this should be. There we go. That's gone nicely into position. And then we're just left with number three. Just a little bit of watch on that one. Slip that behind that post. Slide it there. That should hold that. There we go. Alright, now we can use a cotton bud. I had already blackened this section out, so this will just aid the lighting, because the doesn't matter about the blackout here with that black paint on. Excellent stuff. There we go, that's all three in place. Now I'll put the PCB back on and the funnel. There we go, that's the funnel and the PCB now in place. There we have two adhesive strips, like I said before, to replace. So we take that one off, just like we did before with the other one, and we replace them with these shorter ones just across those two LEDs, just like that. And same on this other PCB. There and there, like that. So they don't want the end LEDs covering with anything. Excellent stuff. Now I think we're ready to put this onto the decking. So now we got the superstructure here. So there's the first funnel, the second funnel, and we have the decking. Now these are for the smoke generators. So this first one will go through here, like so. That one will go through there. This one will go through here. Sorry, the second smoke generator, second funnel, will go through there, and the else, and the PCB, the LED PCB, will go through here. So this is going to be quite fiddly. So I'll just grab that, pull that through there, and pull that through there, making sure we don't snag anything. Hold that there like that. And now what we can do, we can place these superstructure on top like this, and that one through there, and that one through there, like so. You can pull more wiring through so it doesn't snag. There we go. There we go. Now we can pop that into place. There we are. Turn that on its side. And as you can see, there's all that cabling. Now, before we connect the cabling up to the relevant PCB, we'll screw this superstructure to this decking. And this is when we need the 12 AP screws. Okay, now we got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 screws. It doesn't matter which one we start with, because the first one will just hold that deck in nicely in place anyway, like that. And now it means I can speed up this video. There we go, Oh, 12 screws in place. Excellent stuff. Now we can do the wiring. Okay, now we've got the wiring to put in place. So these two cables and the interconnect these three boards. I've took a screw out of there because I think it will interfere with plugging into J3. So first of all, J2 to J3. And it's not going to be easy. I can't actually see it. Now I've got this, the funnels balanced on boxes. There we go, that's that in there. And that end goes in there. We need to put that screw back afterwards. Okay, okay, now we've got this cable, which is 48E, runs from J1 to J3. It doesn't matter which end you do first. That can go in there like so. This can come around here. Get that the right way around. Yeah. There we go. That is that now in place. Excellent stuff. Well, there we go, I'll put that screw back in place now. That's the only one that seems to interfere. So don't worry about putting the other 11 in. Okay, no, we just got these two left. These are from the PCBs, from the superstructure. So we'll go to J2 and J4. And then we can do a light test. That one in there. Let's turn this plug around. There we go. Obviously, the funnels don't get connected. As you can see, there's no sockets for them anyway. Now we can do a light test. Okay, let's do the first light test. There we go. That's all of them lit up nicely, looking brilliant, lovely jubbly. And there we go. So all of my LEDs work perfectly. Excellent stuff. We'll do another light test a little bit later with less lighting in the room. Okay, now we've got one last thing to do with this decking. Is here on 50D, we need to cover that hole where that cable comes out. Ensure that cable stays away from that post and just put that sticker in place just there. So there we go, that is step 6. That is the square 61M, should be in that position there with that cable underneath it. Keep it away from that post, just covers that hole up. Excellent stuff. Let's move on. Okay, now we've got 60L and 60M, which are these two pipes, or multiple pipes. That one goes there like that, and that one will go there like that. Now you can glue them into place or just press them into place. It's exactly up to you. I should say entirely up to you. So they don't always necessarily go in first time. Anyway, that's a nice tight fit, that one. And I think that one, there we go, that one's gone in. Yeah, that's gone in nice and bonny, that one. So just ease them in, and if you they don't go in or don't stay in, you can glue them. Excellent. There we go. Excellent, they're pressed into place, no problem. They don't need any glue at all. That's brilliant. Excellent stuff. Now what we need is the vent that we assembled in issue 60. This is 60J and 60K, and that just fits into them two holes there and there over that pipe. Just fits nicely there. Now mine is a little bit loose, so I'm going to glue that into place. Don't need much glue. There we go, that'll hold that nicely. Excellent stuff. Now we can move on to the hull of the ship. But before that, I think we'll do another light test in the dark. Okay, look, we'll start with the overhead. There we go. Excellent stuff. That looks superb. That looks really bonny. Brilliant. Okay, now we've got this whole section, which will go on here, just here, like this. Pop that in there, hook that around, and now we want 1, 2, 3, 4 LM screws. So here we have, you need the Allen key for this normally, but I fished out one of the toolboxes. That was a free gift. Excellent stuff. There we go. There's an overhead shot of that new section. Excellent stuff. Now all we need to do is put that cross support in place. Okay, so there's that cross support with it facing up like that. You pop it over there, just bring the hole together. Now we have 1, 2, 3, 4 AM screws for this. Okay, as always, a little bit of oil on that screw. Excellent stuff. There we go. So there we go, guys. That's issue 64 completed. Excellent stuff. Now, it's very prominent here, but not so down here. That's because I used wax on this section here and here. So I think I'll probably be doing the same, but I don't need to do it straight away. We can just see how it develops for now. Brilliant. You've seen the decking. That wiring can be a little bit fiddly. I did put all 12 screws in initially because I didn't want that decking to fall off whilst we were doing the wiring. But you, so really, you could just put it, tap in half a dozen screws, because there was one that was just getting in the way of one of the plugs when you settle that. So excellent, just bear that in mind. So anyway, that is it for this month. 61, 62, 63 and 64. Excellent stuff. So if you did like that, give us a big thumbs up, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you next month for the next 4 issues. Excellent. Thanks for tuning in and watching. Stay safe. Bye for now.